Connie Martinson Talks Books. My guest today, Victor Villaseda, has captured, using his life and the lives of those he loves, in a trilogy of books called Rain of Gold. But this is a book called Beyond Rain of Gold, and it's published by Hay House. Welcome, Victor.
Gracias. I'm very happy to be here.
I am too.
And you're beautiful in turquoise.
Gracias, senor. The other books have had a marvelous sort of naivete to them. This one is right to the groin and beginning with, with your father, who now is an old man, and age has not helped him or sat well with him.
What happened is my father, on New Year's Eve, told us, este año me voy a ir, this year I'm going to go.
Yeah.
I want to go visit mi mamá en el otro lado, I want to go visit my mother on the other side and all our antepasados, all our ancestry. And we said, what are you talking about, you want to go? And he said, I'm going this year. And he said, to heaven? What are you talking about? He said, I'm through with my life here on earth, I'm leaving. So we thought he was joking, but no, he started eating less. He'd still have his martini made, but he'd only put his finger in it. And he started getting weak and weak, and he passed over 3 months later.
Yeah.
In those 3 months, people came from Mexico, the entire Southwest, to visit him, and he'd take their hand and rub it, and he'd say, how are you? Are you happy? And then they'd say, oh, you know, I got this business deal, or I got this. He says, that's bullshit. Are you happy?
Yeah.
And he'd zero in on them. And then he said, if you're not happy, you get happy. That's all we got.
But Victor, this is after he's already been through, I would say, the shoals of hell, when he had made so much money, and he joins what the lodge or whatever it is.
And the Elks Lodge.
The Elks Lodge. And someone says, well, you really should build a mobile home. And he gets into what I would call a scam.
Right.
And what happens then, and the lawsuits, and the guys who would lay a truck down it in the daytime and pull it up at night.
Sewer lines, huge sewer lines. They laid it down and then they stole it and used it on other jobs.
Yeah.
I was overseas in the Army, and my father was old and came out of retirement. And he got conned into building this big park for millions of dollars next near the beach.
Yeah.
It was the last 65 acres we had near the beach out of the 160 acres. And when I got back, it was from the Army, it was all torn apart. The tules, the deer, the swampland, the 10,000 blackbirds, everything was destroyed. And I started crying and crying. My father lost everything.
Because, as I recall, the end of your last book, he's king of all his surveys. You've got the enormous ranch that everybody would come to at Christmas or Thanksgiving for the dinner.
I'm glad you remember. Yeah.
And, I mean, and the relatives. And it was all, you know, what more could you ask for? And then this suddenly brings me down to, this is what can happen to you.
Yes. And I want you to know, my father lost everything.
Yeah.
And right after that, I published my first book, Macho.
Mm-hmm.
And I got married. And Barbara and I got pregnant. And we were going to live in Malibu. We were going to get 20 acres without water or electricity. And I was going to build something there.
Yeah.
We were getting it for $50,000, 20 acres by Malibu. And instead she said, I want to raise our kids with your parents. So we went down there, they had 5 acres left. And I didn't want to go back because it was disastrous. The big ranch was gone. And my father started gardening with his grandson, David, and planting corn. And his health started coming back. And my mother, and we had a second child, Barbara and I, and Barbara would come up here and work in Hollywood. at a advertising company, and I was a home father, house father, and we're doing well, and the kids are getting bigger, and then we've adjusted to no money, and we've adjusted to raising pigs in the swimming pool, and it's like a rundown mansion, and we're fixing it up little by little, the roof's leak. And then my father announced his death on New Year's Eve, like I said. And it became the greatest education of my life. Like Carlos Castaneda, he had Don Juan show him all these other dimensions. Well, the night my father died, he was going to pass over, he said to me, "The reason we have problems on Earth is we don't use all of our senses." And I said, what five senses are you talking about? Which are the five? He said, "What pendejadas are you talking about, five senses? We have 12 or 13, I don't remember." He said, "Once I pass over, I'll talk to my mother, the grandmasters, and I'll come back and visit you at night and educate you." That's what this book is about. I got an education from beyond Reina Gold, beyond life from the other side. For 5 years, my father gave me a college degree, a degree from the other side, and explained to me we have 13 senses, four to the head, three to the heart, six to the soul, how they work. He taught me, moved me from thinking to intuition to psychic powers. All this world of dimensions that I knew nothing about, then miracles started happening. And I bought the original Reina Gold back from Putnam.
Oh, let's tell our friends about that, because that is what a nightmare for a writer. You finally, after what, 275 rejections?
Right.
And it was written from the heart. I mean, having read the book, I know written from the heart how your parents came to this country from Mexico and how your mother had to hide so that she wouldn't be raped by the people, the armies that came in. The horrors that can go on when one is seeking asylum in another country. Beautiful. You finally get a sale. You get an agent who's able to sell it quickly. And then it's like it hit the fan because they start to say, "Oh, wait a minute, this can't have happened. Let's call it fiction."
Phyllis Graham, chairman of the board of Putnam, bought it and paid me a lot of money, $150,000 up front with another $100,000 coming. And they knew it was nonfiction. And Ed Victor, the agent from London, sold it. And then just as they went to publish it, they sent out galleys, they called it fiction, and then she wouldn't return my calls. Alex Haley, I sent the book to his office, Jacqueline, beautiful office woman, contacted Alex Haley. He called me, he said he read it, he said it's world-class literature, don't let him do it.
He said it's your name on the cover.
It's your name on the cover, they can't print it without you. He said, "They're only brave when you don't see the white of their eyes." And I said, "She won't return my calls."
That I couldn't believe.
She wouldn't return. Yeah. So he said, "Well, say you're going to go to New York to see, what do you call it?
Theater."
Theater. He said, white people like that. So I called up and said, my wife and I are going to the theater. I've never been to theater. And then I went there, and now she returned my calls because I'm going to go to see the theater. And we had lunch, and all hell broke loose.
Victor Villasena became a dirty name in her lexicon. Oh. Yeah.
I bought the book back. I was blackballed all over New York.
Yeah.
Had to my mother is old now. My father's already passed over to the other side. And, wow. My mother was brave. She was 80 in her 80s, and yet she mortgaged her home so we could buy the book back. And Barbara helped me get the book back.
Yeah.
And then I became a born-again Texan. Arte Publico in Texas, Houston, Texas,
that's right,
published me for $1,500. And we went on the road, and we only had a few books. We lied and said we had a lot of books. And
Then wasn't that, you said we've published for the paperback, you said, oh, we've sold 100,000 copies or something?
Well, no, that was later. That was another lie.
Yeah, okay.
But to get the first lie going, I said we have like 25,000 copies. We only had 500.
Yeah.
And we're on the road. But then, in the meantime, the Mellon Foundation asked for a book,
yeah.
And Saul Bellows, the Nobel Prize.
Oh, Saul Bellows, yeah.
He read it, and his daughter, and they said it's world-class literature, it's wonderful.
Yeah.
So then they gave us 50,000, we were able to print up more books, we got a sales staff, we became a national bestseller,
yeah.
And all the lies became true.
Yeah.
So they were visions of the future, yeah. And pretty soon then, we sold it to paperback, and we got 150,000, and then suddenly we're selling hundreds of thousands of books.
Were you able to make the ranch larger the way it had been when you were kid? No.
No, it's gone. But we have 5 acres still. We have goats and horses, or we had a horse that died. And the boys are big now.
How old are your sons now?
They're 33 and 31.
They're interesting how you are able to give their reaction to you, Victor, my father. I mean, it's the writer who's able to split himself into two. Because you're being you, and they're being much more sort of like dogmatic and, come on, prove it, Dad.
Well, I got, see, what happened is after my father passed over and he became my guide on the other side, mm-hmm. All these miracles started happening. I mean, in rush hour traffic, all the traffic would be slow in front of me or behind me, and I would be traveling 75, 80 miles an hour.
And you'd get there on time.
And I'd get there, I'd get from San Diego, North San Diego, mm-hmm. to downtown LA in 25 minutes. And to do that, you'd have to be traveling about 150 miles an hour. And my family wouldn't believe it. Then they got in the car and it happened.
Yeah.
So, see, there are other time zones and other energies going on, just like Carlos Castaneda, yeah. with his Don Juan.
Yeah.
And once my father showed me 13 senses, and he showed me the only reason we have problems on Earth is 5 senses is a trap. Once we move into 13, we move into our heart energy, then women are wiser. They're the natural leaders. And once we get into our feminine energy, which the Greeks crushed,
yeah.
and all societies have crushed all over the world, that's what we're going into with 2012. So what this book is about, it's beyond all my other writings.
Yes, it is.
And Hay House and Carlsbad didn't chicken out.
Yeah.
And I was allowed to keep all. My other books were edited by people in back east that have their that are really uptight, mm-hmm. in certain parts of their body, and they could not believe in the world, the indigenous world of the Yaqui Indians, of these other worlds that exist simultaneously here.
Was that the same with Arte de Publico down in Texas?
No, Arte de Publico allowed me to put the stuff back.
Yeah.
Well, they didn't allow me. I put it back in.
Anyhow.
If they wouldn't have gone, I would have, you know, dumped them,
yeah.
too. I'm not going to take any of this.
Yeah,
stuff
you
from
walk.
Yeah.
You walk. There's a point too where you are getting what I guess messages. You've gone to Palm Springs or
Two Bunch Palms
with Barbara, and it's sort of like the second honeymoon.
Right.
And suddenly